Hi everyone, in this tutorial we are going to take a look at the anatomy of posterior cranial fossa. The posterior cranial fossa is a part of the cranial cavity located between the foramen magnum and the temporium cerebelli. It contains the brainstem and cerebellum. This is the most inferior of the fossa. It houses the cerebellum, medulla and bones. Interiorly, it extends to the apex of the petrous temporal. Posteriorly, it is enclosed to the occipital bone, laterally portion of the squamous temporal and the mastoid part of the temporal bone from its wallet. Floor of the cranial cavity is divided into three distinct depressions. They are known as anterior cranial fossa, medial cranial fossa, and posterior cranial fossa. Each fossa accommodates different parts of the brain. The posterior cranial fossa is the most posterior and deep of the three cranial fossa. It accommodates the brainstem and cerebellum. In this article, we shall look at the border contained and the cranial correlation of the posterior cranial fossa. Border of the cranial fossa is comprised of three bones, occipital bones and two temporal bones. Cranial fossa, interiorly and medially, it is bounded by the dorsal cilia of the splenoid bone. This is a large superior projection of the bone that arises from the body of the splenoid. Interiorly and laterally, it is bounded by the superior border of the petrous part of the temporal bone. Posteriorly, it is bounded by the internal surface of the squamous part of the occipital bone. The floor of the posterior cranial fossa consists of the mastoid part of the temporal bone and the squamous. Condylar and basilar part of the occipital bone. The posterior cranial fossa houses the brainstem and the cerebellum. The brainstem is comprised of the medulla oblongata, pons, and the midbrain, and continue down through the foramen magnum to become a spinal cord. The cerebellum has an important role in coordination and fine motor control and motor information here. Alongside the gross anatomical structure of the brainstem and the cerebellum, the posterior cranial fossa also accommodate associated arteries and nerves. Foramina are several bony landmark and foramina present in the posterior cranial fossa. A foramen is simply a hole that allows the passage of structure, usually blood vessel and nerves. The temporal bone of the posterior cranial fossa. The internal equiastic meatus is an oval opening in the posterior aspect of the petrous part of the temporal bone. It transmits the facial nerves, vestibulocochlear nerves, and labyrinthine artery. The occipital bone foramina, a large opening of the foramen magnum. The foramen magnum lies centrally in the floor of the posterior cranial fossa. It is the largest foramen in the skull. It transmits the medulla of the brain, meninges, vertebral arteries, spinal accessory nerves, dural veins, and anterior and posterior spinal artery. Interiorly, an incline known as clavius, contact the foramen magnum with the dorsum cilii. The jugular foramina. The jugular foramina are situated either side of the foramen magnum. Each transmit the glossopharyngeal nerves, vagus nerves, spinal accessory nerves. Internal jugular veins, inferior petrosal sinus, sigmoid sinus, and the meningeal branches of the ascending pharyngeal and the occipital artery. Immediately superior to the anterolateral margin of the foramina magnum is the hypoglossal canal. It transmits the hypoglossal nerves through the occipital bone. Postulatory of the foramina magnum lies the cerebral fossa. These are bilateral depressions that house the cerebellum. They are divided medially by a ridge of bone, the internal occipital crust. The posterior cranial fossa is a deepest and the most capacious of three cranial fossa. It contains the cerebellum, pons, and medulla oblongata. The foramen magnum is located centrally and inferiorly in the posterior cranial fossa. Now look at here. It is the groove of transverse sinus follow and forward reach or back the petrous temporal bone, and then the S-shaped screw downward and forward. mesenteric imaginary canal in the sigmoid sinus, grow in of the jugular foramina, where the imaginary canal in the posterior condylateral canal runs back to the open behind the occipital bone. That completes anatomy of the posterior cranial fossa. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and leave comments below. Thank you for watching.